What I'm about to open is something I've been anxiously waiting for about 2 weeks. It's finally here and I can't hide that I'm eager to get it open and start playing with it. Please join me in this video as I unbox and check out this Raycue docking station for a Mac Mini M4. With a connection diagram in English and in Chinese. Okay, with specifications. This is the unit. It's not plastic. It looks like it's cast aluminum. Mac Mini hub and stand, model DK5A1. This is a USB A to USB-C cable. A flat or blade screwdriver and USB-C to USB-C cable. Too bad it's got a wrinkle in it, but hopefully that's not a problem. A bag with screws. That's the end of the box. Nice box though. Let's look at the docking station. On the back,
this is a USB-C port for an optional 5-volt 3-amp power supply.
3.5 millimeter audio jack.
USB 3 with a USB-A connector limited at 5 gigabits per second.
HDMI 4K at 60 hertz. And the docking port. And I'm assuming, I haven't checked yet, that hole is for resetting the unit. On the front, another USB 5 gigabit per second port, USB 10 gigabit per second port, another 10 gigabit but in USB-C, and two card slots. And unlike the page this is advertised on, the ports are labeled. I'm really glad of that, because there's a big difference between 5 gigabits per second and 10. On the bottom, there's nothing but feet.
On the top, fins to distribute the air from the Mac Mini's cooling fan, and two screws that hold on the plate under which an M.2 NVMe SSD can be installed.
Let's open up the enclosure and see what's inside it. I thought I would see the board with the chips, but I don't. Okay, let's put in the SSD.
Before going any further, I want to get a sense of how fast an SSD operates in the Raycue dock versus an external SSD enclosure I've been using for a while. The way I'm going to do it is this.
Try out an SSD in this enclosure. See what the speed is with Blackmagic speed test, and then do the same thing with the same SSD in here. So let me get that set up and give it a go.
To reduce the number of variables, I'm going to use the same cable for both speed tests, the cable that came with the Raycue dock. The SSD I'm using is a Lexar NQ790 2GB NVMe 1.4. Its top speed is supposed to be between 6 and 7,000 megabits per second, so it should not be the bottleneck. With the Ugreen enclosure, I get just under 970 megabits per second for writing, and just under 870 megabits per second for reading. With the Raycue dock, I get just under 960 megabits per second for writing, and just under 845 megabits per second for reading. There is a difference, with the Raycue being slower, but in real-world situations, the difference is negligible. Now that we know how well this performs as a SSD enclosure, let's see if it suffers the same weakness as other USB hubs for the M4 Mac Mini, that is, issues with Wi-Fi. I watched a Mr. H Tech video where he looked at a nicely designed hub with like an airspace between the base and the computer, and he couldn't get any Wi-Fi signal. Let's find out if this works with Wi-Fi, or if this is going to be a colossal fail and that I'll have to return it. I can say without any fear of contradiction, I am not experiencing any problems with Wi-Fi as a result of the Raycue dock. That's a great relief. Now that I've determined that this Raycue dock works, I have to decide if it is useful to me. The answer is yes and no. I really like having many ports available, especially a selection of high-speed USB-A and USB-C ports, but in truth, I want them all to be at the back of the dock, not at the front. Okay, I'll take one USB-A and one USB-C port plus the card reader at the front, but I want to divert all the other cables to where I can't see them. For the same reason, I don't like having extra hubs and docks around because they take away from the real estate of my desk. The next thing I regret about this Raycue dock is the speed. Ideally, I would have liked it to be at least Thunderbolt 3 speed, but I have to be realistic. For this price, about 100 and change, Thunderbolt 3 or better is not available, at least not yet. Fortunately, I still have a bunch of unused Thunderbolt ports at the back of the Mac Mini. My last beef with the Raycue is a consequence of the dim-witted design of the Mac Mini. You know what I'm talking about, the on-off switch. I've heard plenty of reviewers say, "Oh, I never turn it off, so I don't care about the switch." When you make an excuse for this ergodynamic boner, forgiving the charging port at the bottom of a mouse is not that far away. It would have been better if this dock could have ameliorated Apple's design flaw, like some of the other Mac Mini M4 docks on the market have. But in terms of what's available on the market at the end of 2024 for the M4 Mac Mini, I think this is the best there is. By this time next year, though, it may be a different story.
I hope you enjoyed this video from Mr. Brown's Basement. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Every subscriber helps. If you have any questions, I'll do my best to answer in the comments section.